Hello, welcome to a new session. In this session, we are going to discuss about how to generate an extended report using Cucumber. So there are so many types of extended reports are there with a different type of people have generated it. Some they generate it through a runner class, some they generate it through a XML configuration, some they generate it through a method like object. So I'm going to generate the extended report which will look like this. Where is the report? This it will look like this. Okay, so my test is failing. That's the reason all the this chart is coming as a red. And if this is a test, and the description of this test is this. Now I've written some logs here, so that's the reason logs are coming. And in the after annotations, I'm failing the test because the test has got fail. I'm checking whether the test has passed or failed. Based on that, I'm reporting it. Okay. So this is a dashboard. You have filters, a lot of things are there. We'll generate the report and I'll show you. Okay, what do you need it? So I have used this event stack jar extend report. There are so many reports are there. Cucumber extend report is there. Then there is a Vimel salvage report is there. So many reports are there, but I found this one is the most simplest one and very straightforward. No more configuration, no XML, nothing is required. Just simple create an object and start generating the report. Okay, so this jar is needed. I have taken the latest version of the jar. You can go and check it. What is the latest version? You can put it into the Maven dependencies. Now, so in the runner class, what I did it, I have given the argument like where to generate the report. So this report.html is the path where I'm generating the report. Okay, so I'm creating an object of HTML report, then object of extend report, you can see it, and then attaching the report into the then attach reporter is a method where I'm passing the HTML report where the HTML report would be residing. Then doing some environment configurations, like you can this environment configurations will come into the report, basically the browser, OS, extend report demo, name of the report, what is the theme, like standard, what is the time format you want, all this you can do it. If you don't do it, a default will come. Okay, but if you want to set it something like if you are running on a browser called Chrome, or if you are running on a Firefox, or you are running on a Linux environment or on a Windows environment, you can set the parameter here, or you can pass it from the JVM argument. Okay, minus D, you can pass it like Maven clean install minus D, and the parameter like OS equal to Linux, or OS is equal to Fire like window, browser is equal to Firefox, or browser equal to Chrome, or equal to I, whatever it is, it will take automatically. Just you have to write system.get property and it will take it. Okay, now go to the runner class. In a common step, like before, you need to initiate the test. When I say initiate that, like one test, when a execution happened in a Cucumber, what happened? It's first one scenario get executed, then again another scenario get executed like that. So here also, we are whenever new scenarios getting executed, it will go into the before annotation and it will create a test. When I say test, this test will get created. Okay. Okay, so this test will get created and I'm just giving the test case name and some description. If you want to give some description, you can give the description. If you don't want to give the description, don't give it. I have hard coded it. You should not hard code it. You can take it from the scenario name, directly embed the scenario name here. Okay, test case and the scenario name. And here you can generate some counter 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Like how many scenarios are running, you can generate the counter. So let me do it. In this of talking, let me do it. So in the, I can put it here like same as the scenario name or the scenarios come, and here I can put it like test case I can put it I, and then whenever I'll just put in a variable int counter equal to 0, and whenever one test case get executed, and after scenario, I'll make the counter is equal to plus plus. So second test case, it will come like that. Okay. So first test case, second test case like that, it will come. Okay, counter argument. So it will just replace with I as a counter here. Two. Now I have got the test object here, like first test case object. I have got it. With the help of this object, I'll just put a set, getters and setters. So you can see it, I have put it as a private variable, and I have created a getter setter so that I can get that test in any of the steps. Correct. So if I go here, I have taken that test here, common step dot get test dot debug. I put our debugger here. User open the browser and enter the URL. So this debugger will go into the report. So if you want to write some debug, you want to write some info, you want to write some error, you want to embed some screenshot in any of the steps, you can do it with this extend report. So extend report give you more flexibility the way you want to generate your own report. If you want to write multiple infos each steps, you can write that multiple infos. So suppose I'm writing after every steps, I'm writing something. Page open, title is verified, something like title, something is, I'm writing it every places wherever I need to write it. So you can see it here also. I will write some more, like after screenshot I'm just putting some text. Test executed, something like that. Whatever you want to write it, you can write it. You want to take the screenshot, I have taken the screenshot, it will come there also. And okay, so two places I have put the screenshot, two places I put the loggers basically. And when I test case run, it will generate the report. So to let the generate multiple report, let me take the whole feature file. So many test cases will come, so it will be easy to understand. Okay, so let me go and put the annotations. So what you need, one jar only, and some object like HTML report object where you want to place the report, and then extend, start the report. This is basically the starter. And after class, in the runner class, I have created two annotations, before class and then after class. In after class, I'm just flushing it. It means all, when all the scenarios execution get finished, just flush. This means finish the report and generate the report. So that extend.flush, I'm doing it. You can see it, correct? So first the path, then the extend object, and the extend object I'm passing the path of the report, and with the help of that extend object into the runner common class, I'm generating a test, which for each test one steps will generate on the left hand side. So this test will generate for each step. So for that only I'm writing one dot create is the test. You can see it, create test, and I'm giving the test case name and description. And after that, from that I'm getting an object called test. With the help of test, I'm writing all the things like pass, fail, taking the screenshot, embedding it, everything I'm doing. You can see it, test.log, test. If it is pass, just do like this. If it is fail, do like this, like that. I'm putting it. So let me run it. So first one test case only, it will open the browsers and then do some testing and all, and close other tests. Just I have given the messages and all, so it will get executed very fast, nothing to worry. Okay, so all the test cases will keep on doing. Yeah, tuck, it will do, keep on doing, because I'm just opening the browser and closing it, opening the browser and closing it, and all of the test cases, just to check all the test cases are getting executed or not, and then we are getting all the reports or not. So this extend report is very useful when we have to show so many things, like detailed things, like each steps what you are doing it, each step what screenshot you want to take it, all the details. If you want, you can generate it. You can see, so I see test case 0 0. Okay, somehow I have just missed some places, look like that's why it's 0 0 coming. And then you can see it, the description of the test, like you can see verify the integer test input. Okay, parameter from steps, first one is SRC 001. So like this, all the test cases are coming. So this has all passed. But for the first test, I have given so many steps. You see, so many loggers are generating, and then the screenshot. Two places I have taken the screenshot. So two screenshots are got embedded here. Thanks for watching my video.